Welcome everyone to the Beaver County Softball Network. We are here at Aniline Park and we will stream a 10U game between Beaver Maroon and Central Valley Navy, I believe. So this is BCFPL, the league. And we're still playing regular season games. We'll get into the playoffs here pretty soon. I am trying to stream down here in 720, I believe, to try to figure things out as far as streaming the championship games that we're going to host at this facility. We have 8U, 10U, and 12U championship games, so I need to figure out the streaming. We have a weaker signal down here, so like I said, I am streaming in 720, so it may not be as clear as other games, but just trying something new. So we have the umpire, that is Sherry, if you don't know her. And we have the CB coach and the Beaver coach, and they're going over ground rules. So we should get started here very shortly. If you're on Facebook, please follow us, like our page. We're pushing to monetize everything so we can pay for the network and not have to charge anybody. So right now we're free, and that's how we hope to stay. And like I said, as long as our audience picks up and interacts with our Facebook pages, our YouTube channel, all that stuff, we should be able to cover the expenses. We're also on Instagram, the same handle, and we are obviously on YouTube that you're watching right now. So if you aren't subscribed, please do. Every subscription counts. I think we're almost at 950. And I hope to get to 1,000. Here, I'll put this on now. But I hope to get to 1,000 by July. At least that was my original goal. I should get to it sooner than that. Then once you get there, then you can monetize on YouTube and start paying for some of the expenses to have this network. Pretty cool to take advantage of social marketing. And okay, so let me see if I can find the lineups, and then we will we're running late. This game was supposed to start at 7:15, so we're about 15 minutes late. And actually, I'm gonna start the timer, so the time games are, what is it? 90? I think it's 90 minutes. That's what we're going to go with. And we're dropping frames here, so if the network doesn't settle down and get stable here soon, I'll upload the entire game when I get home tonight, so everyone has it and can watch the whole thing instead of watching it in and out. Okay, so here we go. First pitch is a ball. Batting for Beavers, number 14. Oh, that was high. And CB pitching is number 9. And like I said, that internet, the cellular connection's so bad down here. Trying to find out who's online I can follow. There's a swing and a miss. So we got 3 balls and 1 strike. Swing and a miss. Full count. Called strike 3. That'll be the first out. Oh, that one got away from her. So the only team I can find on Game Changers is CB's team, and it's not updating. So we might fly through this with, there's a swing and a miss, with no rosters, which it's not a big deal, won't be the first time. Miss low. There's a pop up. Hit the backstop foul ball. Called strike 3. So that'll be 2 outs. There's the first pitch. On this batter, why did I don't hear my audio. There we go. There's a called strike. It's weird how much better a stream is when you have sound, like the sounds of the game. The pop out of gloves, the... You know, the bats, the cheers. Makes it more fun to watch. My network is just getting crushed right now.
Coach, we got 2 strikes.
All right, so here comes the coach. And I think there's 1 strike. There's a play. Back to the pitcher. And she gets the out at first. All right, so that's three outs. We have no runs scored, so we'll be back with the bottom of the first. Something new. I'm moving my shop to Etsy. I'm getting a lot of heat from my kids, but the reason why I'm doing it is the catalog is really organized and nice there. But if you are from Beaver County or around the area and you want something, email me. Don't buy it through Etsy, because there's a lot of charges and stuff that we can avoid, and I can get it done cheaper than through Etsy. But definitely look and see what's out there, and if there's anything that interests you, please let me know. I'm adding things as often as I can, so I can do like bag tags, MVP awards. I can make the like wooden plaques, things like that, for sponsors or tournaments or strike three. And I still don't have a roster. Backstop. I don't know if the umpire knew that right away.
I thought I heard it hit the cage. Then I was like, how did it get all the way?
Hey, Beaver, let's be ready.
Miss Lowe. One and one count. Swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Ooh, she called strike three. I just assumed that was outside because the catcher missed it. No, I think Cook or the blue might have missed that one. It happens. Getting the ball. I wonder what was going on. She hit that one pretty hard, but it was out of play. Her cell signal is just bad right now. There's a swing and a miss. Shot over the right center's head, and she's gonna go three. She'll be safe. Oh, she crushed that one. So there are, I'm not gonna be able to see the scoreboard either, but there are two outs, I believe. I don't have game changer. I don't see the scoreboard. I have poor cell signal. There's a foul ball. Tie on that one. That was a little bit high. There's a hit. That's going to be fair. It'll score the first run. Do have the time counting down on the scoreboard if you haven't noticed. This is the bottom of the first. There's a called strike. CB is leading 1-0. And I'm fighting cellular connections down here. Swing and a miss. Slow. It's a hit. That's going to get past the right fielder. Scores another run. And she'll stay at second with a double. Oh, she swung at that one. That was high. Helping the pitcher out a little bit. Swing and a miss, strike three, stolen base attempt, and she'll be there.
Oh,
was that three outs? Yeah, it looks like it was three outs. Stolen base doesn't count. All right, so after one, Central Valley is up 2-0. We'll be right back. Figure out this live streaming stuff here down here at this terrible cellular connection. There's strike three on the batter. Called strike. Again, I don't have the lineups, so there's a pop up, and that is going to be, it's going to fall in front of the second baseman. So that'll go in the book as a hit. I don't think there was an error or anything, it was just misplayed. So Beaver has their first base runner. Now it looks like I actually have a decent connection now. So that she got a delayed steal, but she's going to be safe. So they tried to pick her off. First, and she took off for second, and she was safe. Aggressive base running, that's what you like to see. There's a called strike. It was high. That's going to get past the catcher, and runner will get the third unattested. So we have a 2-2 count on this one, this batter here. Oh, inside. Full count. That one's high. Ball four. So there are two strikes. And this is 10-U, so if you aren't sure of the rules, when ball four happens, the coach comes in and finishes the strike count. So this batter had two strikes. So she has one strike or four pitches. And she can't finish her at bat on a foul. There's a hard hit up the middle. That'll score a run for Beaver. It's an RBI single. Almost takes the coach's head off. So there's one out, and there's rules in place that if there's less than two outs, so if there's zero outs or one out, the base runner on first base can't steal second. They can only do that with two outs. Called strike. Now, if the catcher throws down the first, they can run. That was just a new rule that was voted in this offseason, this past offseason. It's a swing and a miss. So we got one ball and two strikes. Missed high. So we got even count at two. Three balls and two strikes. I think I hit her bat. Yeah, that hit her bat. It'll be a nice short for my When Balls Attack series. There's a called strike three. Strike. Oh. Looks like there was some action here. Umpire got up for some reason. There are two outs now, so that base runner on first can go. Ooh, that got her. She didn't even try to get out of the way. Whack. She looks okay. She shook it off like a champ. Here she is on first. When Balls Attack. That's crazy. She took it. All right. So we have runners on first and second, I believe. And there is two outs. That was high. Base runner thought about running, but that's a strike. So we got a 1-1 count. Another called strike. So it's a 1-2 count. That one missed high. The runners are going to advance and she'll be safe. throw was pretty on. Just the tag was a little slow. She was kind of out of position to make that tag. That's called strike. That'll be three. So it's, what we got? 1.5 done. It's 2-1 Central Valley. We'll be back with the bottom half of the second. Okay, so if you go to request.bcsoftballnetwork.com, you can actually go in. This is my calendar when I'm available. And the Blue Days, you can actually click on there and request to have me stream your game. So if there's any games you want me to stream, please go out there and check it out. That's request.bcsoftballnetwork.com. Like our network is dropping packets again. This facility, as nice as it is, and it's a good venue for games, but not streaming. The cell signal down here is just terrible. It's high. Which is unfortunate because we're hosting the championship games and I want that to be live. And it's going to be challenging. There's things that I can do, but of course it costs money. So I really don't want to spend that money now and would rather spend it during the tournaments, the championship games. There's a ball play. Shortstop throws it and makes the play at first. Nice play. Got past the pitcher there, but she picked it up and made a nice throw. Called strike on the first pitch. This is the bottom of the second. What's going on? batted out of order. So this batter, since the batting team caught it, they're able to switch the batters. If the team in the field would have caught it, I believe that batter would have been out. So this batter just continues to bat. So there are two outs now. Called strike. Swing and a miss. So you got one ball and two strikes. Check swing by the batter. My network has crashed hard right now. It's a foul ball. Did that hit her? Yeah, I think I did hit her. Swing a miss, strike three. Is that the inning? Yes, it is. All right, so after two, we have CB up 2-1. We'll be back with the top of the third with Beaver bat. So our local travel team here is Valley Rage. They've been around for 25 years. This will be their 25th year anniversary. They're hosting tournaments, so they finished two already. They have one more to go here in the middle of July. It's the Rage in the Valley. This is travel tournament, so not sure if you want your rec teams to go there, but a lot of these girls that play in the Beaver County Fast Pitch League do play for Valley Rage, and you know they're big supporters of the network, so I like to support them. So they've had three tournaments. This is the second year that they'll host these three tournaments, so they're doing a good job with it. It's not easy to host tournaments. A lot of work is involved. If you did join us, we're watching 10U Beaver County Fast Pitch Ball. And the streams aren't the best right now. So, very intermittent. connection, lots of drops packets, and poor network. So if you are watching, please be patient while we get through this. There's a called strike. And I will upload the entire game. I'm recording it locally, so I'll be able to upload it. And there's strike three. That'll be the first out. But you'll at least get to watch it later in its entirety. I need Elon Musk to give me his network. Wonder if I can ask for a sponsorship. Because I'm not paying no $100 a month for it. My wife might divorce me on that one. Caught strike. There's a swing and a miss. It's a three, call strike three. So there's two outs. We have two strikeouts this inning so far. That's a shot and caught. Nice play. That'll end the inning. I think that was left center that came in and made that catch. Nice job. Okay, so that was top of three. So we'll be back with the bottom half of the third inning with CB still up 2-1. All right, so if you're on Facebook, please follow us and like our Facebook page. And the reason why is the more you do that, the more I get paid, or the network gets paid. It's monetized right now on Facebook. So, when you see the any posts that I put up there, if you like them, share them, interact with them in any way, the social marketing will kick back a few bucks for the network. And that's how I use this to keep it free for everybody. So I'm using social marketing to pay for everything. And it's really not picked up yet, but it's doing well enough, or it's starting to do pick up. Yeah, so right, so what I did was I completely bailed on the stream because it was not working, and I wasn't able to record in high def, so I've decided to kick the stream and just record locally in high definition. So from here on out, the game will at least look a little bit better. It'll have to be on a delay, but so be it. There's a swing and a miss. That'll be strike three. So that's two strikes or two outs in this inning. CB is still winning 2-1 here in the bottom of the third, I believe. There's a foul ball off the fence. Oh, this field. This field is going to kill me. It's a fair ball. Gets through the outfield. She's going to get two. And she's going to go three. She'll be safe. The ball got in the infield pretty quick, but runner, she didn't stop. No interest in stopping. Swing and a miss. So there is a runner on third base with two outs. And this is one of CB's bigger bats. So let's see what can happen here. Missed high. Time has been called. I don't know why. Not sure what's going on there. Let me turn on my mic again. Call strike. There's a shot, and that's going to be out of play. A little bit behind that. Missed high. What, yeah, 2-2, I think.
Three balls, two strikes.
She got a full count on the batter. That's a shot. That's over center's head. It's going to reach me. And she's going to be in there for... Did she stay at third or did she go all the way in? Yeah, she stayed at third. So it does score another run. So it's 3-1. And we have her. This is her younger sister. Both these girls are pretty good ball players. Coming up through CB system. Swing and a miss. Hey, You heard the ump. Three balls and one strike. There are two outs, runner on third base. Ball four. So one strike on the batter, and the coach is going to come in. And let's see what happens here. Called strike. That's a shot. And that's over center's head. And she'll get two there. She went for the swing, that's for sure. So it is 4-1. And we have a base runner at second base. And she's stealing for third, and she'll be up. Called strike. There's a shot. That's going to be foul.
One ball, two strikes.
It's actually a nice swing. She's got to throw her hands out away from her body instead of pulling them across her body. That was actually a nice swing. She's going to be pulling everything. But she hits it hard.
Hanger! Circle, circle, circle!
And they got stuck in a pickle. She'll be safe. Oh, she's going to go two. Oh, she'll be up. So that scores another run.
Next effort, number six, Ellie, the batter.
Yeah, that batter that had that nice hit there, she's just breaking her wrist way too early. She's got to extend his arm and get even more power. There's a swing and a miss. Miss low again. So the count is 1-1. I think that umpire before, we didn't know what was going on. It was the, sounds like there's kids outside the dugout, which isn't safe. Strike.
Two balls, two strikes.
She got a 2-2 count. That's a nice hit. That's going to fall in front of center for another RBI. And another double. So I think that 6-1, 5-1. They have a scoreboard up. I still don't have game changer, so I don't know. That looks like a 6 to me, so that's 6-1. First pitch was a ball on this batter. shot. That falls in front of the left fielder. And they're going to send her home. She'll be up. That's another RBI. And that is seven. That was obstruction over there at third. But doesn't matter. They scored five and walked the inning off. So we'll be back with the top of the fourth. See if Amherst can get some of these runs back. So our playoff brackets, or tournament, I guess, will begin on June. It's actually going to be Friday, June 14th. The AU teams will play their first round of the elimination round. And turn this down a little bit. They're having a little bit too much fun back there. But, yeah, so their first two games are played to seed everyone into the bracket. And we have the 8U, 10U, and 12U championship games. So 8U will be new this year. And they're all going to be played at this facility. And I'm hoping to stream them, but I'm not sure what we're going to do. I might just have to record them and upload them later. Streaming is almost impossible down at this place. So you got a 3-0 count on this batter. CB had a big inning last inning. They were up 2-1, and then they put five up on that last inning. It's a nice shot, and it's going to fall in right center for a double. She'll be safe there. She tried to go for three. I did the replay on the swing.
Nice job, Ed.
Well, but she took off her third and almost got thrown out. But she is safe. So she'll have a double and advance to third on a throwing error. So there are no outs. It's a swing and a miss. Batter's pulling out of the box when she swings. Get it. Look how far away she is from the plate. Get those toes on that white line. The slope. There's a nice hit. Caught by short. Nice play. away from the pitcher. Nice pick by the catcher back there, working hard. Tie. So that'll be ball four. How many strikes?
No strikes.
So she got four pitches or three strikes. Let's see what happens here. It's a bomb play. Short gets it. Throws the first, but it's not going to be in time. And she's going to go two. I don't know if that was a bad throw or if the, it was a little low. Girl's pretty quick. That does score another run for Beaver. There's a hit. Nice try by Short, but it gets through and they're going to score a run. That's a nice hit. So that scores another run. It's 7-3. Pitch the ball. Missed high. What's the count, Blue? 3-0 is the count. Missed low. So the batter has no strikes. So the coach is going to come in and let's see what happens here. Runner on second base. There's a ball back to the pitcher. Gets past her. And she'll be safe. Play it. The plate. She dropped it. She'll be safe. So, Beaver scores three. Coach had a whole lot to say there. Missed inside. Where's the base runner at? She's still at first. So there must only be one out because she didn't go. So I'm assuming there's one. Call strike. She went after that one. That was a little high. Called strike three. So now there's two outs, runner on first. I imagine she's going to go here on the first pitch. There she goes. She'll be safe. So we got two outs, runner on first base. Called a strike, a little bit outside. I can't really see where the plate at, so it's not really fair. But I think that was kind of in the river a little bit. That's a strike. The only thing with umpires, everyone's strike zone's different. So you have to learn how to adjust to it. Called strike three. And that should end the inning. All right, so Beaver gets a couple back, so they're back in this game. CB's up 7-4 with their turn to bat here in the bottom fourth. Thanks for watching. Like sponsorships, stuff like that I can do. There's also like magnets. I sent those out for the BCSN All-Star teams for the varsity players. Then there's cooling towels. And then I'm going to start putting a lot of stuff out there for mobile live stream. So I'll have fence mounts, cool boxes, different things like that some people would find interesting or find helpful. Your first pitch is a strike. But anything you buy through the BCSN shop all goes to the network and helps cover the expenses of it. And if you do go to the shop, don't order anything on a shop. If you're you're local, Beaver County, or whatever, or even if you're just watching, email me. And then well, you get better deals that way. Like, there's a lot of shipping charges and other expenses that we can avoid if you just go directly to me. If you haven't noticed, I'm cheap. Trying to do things that is cost effective. Oh, that hit my camera. Took it like a champ. Look at that. Let's not do that again. Okay, so we got ball four. And coach comes in, got two strikes. So we got one strike or four pitches. Let's see what happens. So that's one pitch. Yeah, that Etsy shop, I can do pretty much anything. So if you're looking for something, like as gifts or awards or memorial stuff, let me know. I can figure it out. There's a hit to pitcher. And she's going to be out. There's a called strike. See that one pitch hit the camera. The camera that I'm using back there is it's a GoPro, so they can take shots like that. And I have a setting where it's self-leveling. So even if it gets knocked crooked, it'll still be level. There's a call strike. There's a lot of tricks like that doing this stuff. So that's strike three. I think that's two outs. First pitch is a strike, swinging. There's another strike. We got two balls and two strikes. That one missed low. So we missed strike three. That'll end the inning. So after four, we have CB up 7-4. We'll be right back. steps out. So here we are with the top of the fifth inning with CB up 7-4. I mean, really, the big difference in this game is that one inning where CB got five runs. So here we go. First pitch of the fifth inning. Called strike. That one was slow. One on one's account. Again, no one's doing game changers, so I can't follow the rosters. So I wasn't able to announce any names this game. Heard someone say they changed the rules. The league never changed rules for the masks. I don't think USA Softball ever required infielders to wear masks, just the corners. And I don't even think that was a requirement. It's really up to the districts on how they do that. I don't think we have anything in the Beaver County rulebook for that. I could be wrong, but it's not the infield. It's, if anything, it's the corners and pitcher. Curious, so I'm gonna look it up. You can look up the league rules. It's on Beaver County FastPitch.com. And there's league rules there. So you go into the menu. Just tie on the ball. 3-1 count on the batter. See if I can do this without missing anything on the game.
Ball four.
So here comes the coach. So general equipment rules. I'll read this after this batter. Foul ball.
There's a swing and a miss. Okay, so according to the Beaver County rules, this is in general equipment rules, section D. Infield face masks and heart guards are strongly encouraged in this league. This tie. But USA Softball code will be used for infield equipment rules. So that doesn't tell us much of anything because I don't know the USA code.
Hey, strike. There's a hit over the pitcher's head. And they're going to get her out at first. Nice play. That'll be three outs. That was like a check swing almost. It's a nice play. All right, we'll be back, and I will have the rules, hopefully, for this face mask deal. Okay, we'll be back. We are back. First pitch is a strike. And I'm looking at USA code, and there is nothing specific with masks. So the masks can be worn at the coach's discretion. Doesn't matter. The only thing that's in the USA code is the mask can't be cracked or deformed in any way. They have to be functional. So I'm not sure what that one coach was saying when they said the rules changed. Rules never changed. But it's up to the discretion of the coaches, parents, and each of the districts. You know, if they want to require face masks, they can. But from a league in USA code, it's not necessary. And that batter took her helmet off before she was in a dugout. That is also, that shouldn't be done. So that umpire should have said something. She has to keep that helmet on when she's on the field of play. Just one out. Here's a strike. Ball inside. That's the thing that's tough with rules. You know, there's so many rules, in, especially in the USA softball code. And if something happens in the middle of the game, good luck finding it. Swing and a miss. Is that strike three? It is. So that's two outs. The Beavers looking to get their third out and try to score some before this game's over with time. Time has to be getting close. It's the bottom of fifth. Missed high. Oh. balls and two strikes with two outs.
Two and two, yep.
Full count.
Three balls, two strikes.
It's getting close to my bedtime. It's a foul ball. It's a nice hit. Good contact there. Good eye. So there's two strikes on the batter. Here comes the coach. One strike or four pitches. Pop up. And it's going to be fair. Did she catch it? Touch it? I guess she touched it. Oh no, she's calling it foul. So I wasn't sure if she touched it or not. I waited too long on a replay.
I did. You found it straight up and you swung underneath it.
Whoa, there's a shot. Looks like she's going to stay in the single. She almost killed the coach. Alright, so she's on first. Here comes a couple big bats for Central Valley. There are two outs, I believe. Swing and a miss. Each batter that comes up is going to be a threat for Beaver to run out of time. There's a swing and a miss. Steal attempt, and she'll be safe. Oh, with two count on a batter, two outs. She wanted that one. Runner's going to advance to third. She's got one ball and two counts. Or I'm sorry, one ball and two strikes for the count here. Swing at strike three. That'll end the inning. Time in. Looks like it. All right, so we'll be back for the sixth inning. We'll take a short break. So this game, when you're watching this is going to be a recording. I actually stopped the live stream because it was doing so poorly. But what I'm going to do after I upload the full game is create a video of just the instant replays. So it'll be a way to watch the game, and it'll be a condensed version so you don't have to sit through the full 2 hours. You can just see all the instant replays that I did for some of the top plays. So I'll try to get that up tonight. Depends if I sit on a couch. Typically when I sit on the couch, that's the end of the night, but we'll see. So CD with a sixth inning. This is the last inning, so they need three outs and they'll get the win. Beaver needs three runs to tie it up, so it's in their reach. So let's see what happens. Okay, here's the first pitch. Missed high. There's a foul ball. They hit the camera again. Camera's struggling. It's taking shots, but it's staying up there like a champ. There's a swing and a miss. So we have one ball and two strikes. Oh, that went high. Even to count at two. Swing a miss, strike three. That'll be one out. Here's the second batter this inning. Swing it, or she tipped it. Foul ball, strike one. There's a hit. That's gonna get to the right fielder down the line and she'll go free. And she'll be safe. It's a big hit to keep things alive for Beaver. There is only one out. Now there's a runner on third base. Beaver is down by three, so they need more than that one run on third. But if they can start stacking hits, they might have something going here. There's a swing and a miss. A little bit too aggressive on that. Batter needs to wait for a good pitch. It's slow. Missed high. Oh, they got her stuck. She's going to score. They had her trapped in a pickle, but the third baseman couldn't handle the throw. All right, so it's 7-5. Beaver still has some work to do here. Looks like the pitcher is fanning herself or something. It is hot out here, but it's cooled out significantly. It was so hot when I first got here. Felt like it was in August. Missed high.
3 balls, 2 strikes.
That ball 4. And she has 2 strikes on her. So she has 1 strike or 4 pitches. See what happens. There is 1 out for Beaver. They need this girl on. See if this coach can groove one for her. It's a nice hit. It's a short. She gets the throw to first. And she gets the out. So that's 2 outs. Nice play by short. So there's 2 outs. And Beaver's down to their last out. Nice pitcher.
Head in the bench. Okay, stay ready. There you go.
Swing and a miss.
Come on, 2 strikes.
Beaver's down to their last strike. Swing and miss. Strike 3. That'll be the game. So CB will win 7-5. So thanks for watching. And I really do hope I can figure out live streaming at Anaheim Park. But right now it's winning. So thanks for watching and we'll catch you next time.